Hello. It is I, the potion master, here to teach you how to bottle fame, brew glory, even put a stopper in death.
Hey guys, it's Tessa. And for this video, I am partnering with the Ad Council and the She Can STEM campaign to teach you some basic potions and experiments that you can do at home. I can STEM and so can you. Welcome to potions class. Potion number one. Here are your ingredients. Oil, water, food coloring, a water dropper, some cups, and a spoon. Look at all the ingredients. Put water in several cups and add food coloring to the water.
Put some water in a cup. Now let's add some food coloring
to make the water nice and pretty. And yes, I got colors to represent the four houses, okay?
First, one, two, three. Mixing it up. Mix it. Aha.
All houses represented, like always. Step two, fill another cup with oil.
There you go, look at it. There's the oil. Okay, now step three, the most important step. We're going to take this little dropper and add the colored water to the oil and see what happens.
Hey guys, add a lot of them.
Whoa! Some more house points. It's Christmas.
As you can see, the oil and the colored water do not mix together. Oil is less dense than water, so that's why the water sinks to the bottom.
So what would happen if we just added a bunch of this? It just goes directly to the bottom.
Bill Nye is quaking. Okay, time for potion number two.
We're making slime.
The ingredients you need are dish soap, cornstarch, some food coloring if you want it to be extra colorful, a bowl, and another spoon. Okay, step one, add the cornstarch to the bowl.
Oh, making a mess. Better roll up my sleeves here, you guys. All right, let's put cornstarch in the bowl. Step two, add dish soap.
Ah,
look at it.
We'll add a little bit of food coloring just to make it extra blue. Now we're gonna mix together. Mixing it. Need to add a lot more soap.
Added way too much cornstarch in here.
Aw, yeah.
Let's add a little more cornstarch in there.
I'm like painting my hands with it.
It's a slime hand.
Ah!
This feels so good. I'm just gonna do this the rest of the day. The more cornstarch you add, the thicker the slime and the more putty-like it becomes, and the more dish soap you add, the more runny and liquidy the slime is.
Cornstarch works as a thickener and a binder, so it thickens and binds the dish soap together, forming the sort of slime-like putty.
Look at my creation. Look at that slime.
Potion number three. Here are your ingredients. Baking soda, vinegar,
dish soap. Mine is covered in slime.
Food coloring, a cup, and a spoon.
I just keep using spoons in every experiment.
Here are all my ingredients.
Step one, add vinegar and food coloring to a cup, and then we're gonna stir it up. And then in the cup.
Woo! Let's make this red.
Let's go with red.
Just a few drops of blood.
Just kidding.
It's food coloring. And let's mix it up with nice vinegar blood.
Oh, that stench. So now we're gonna add some baking soda and a dash of the dish soap. We're gonna see the reaction. We're gonna try to do it like right after each other. All right, this is where the science kicks in. Oh dang, give it a little stir. Oh! Look! Oh my god!
It's overflowing!
Oh! Look at that froth! Look at that! It looks so delicious!
Ah!
Now I wanna do it in more colors.
Okay, I'm grabbing more cups so we can do it in more colors.
Let's try it with yellow so it can look like butterbeer.
Baking powder!
Oh yes. Woo! Butter beer.
Spells and enchantments, potions and friends.
Cheers!
I'm making a mess again.
I'm making a mess again, Arnold.
Oh, but this is so much fun. This is my favorite experiment.
Ah! It's like gushing all over my hands.
So when baking soda and vinegar mixes, it releases carbon dioxide.
Oh yeah.
If you add soap to it, the carbon dioxide basically blows bubbles in it, and that's where you can see the little bubbles. But that's the reaction.
Yum, I wanna drink this, but it's vinegar, so I'm not.
I kinda wanna do them all at the same time. Are you guys ready?
Vinegar! Oh my gosh, look you guys, look.
Oopsie, that was fun, making a mess. Well, that is all the time that we have for today.
Class dismissed.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Making these potions was so fun and so easy, and all along I was doing a STEM activity. For those who don't know, STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. And if anyone watching this video has an interest in one of those subjects, especially if you are a girl, I want to encourage you to get involved and to stay involved with STEM, because we need you. Research shows that young girls like these subjects, but when they go to middle school, they start to feel like STEM isn't for them because, number one, they don't have female role models to look up to, and number two, they can't see how these subjects can relate to their everyday lives. But a lot of us use STEM in our lives and we don't even know that we're using it. Like making potions, or making slime, or baking. And a lot of DIY projects that you can find online use STEM related skills. If you enjoy these activities, the She Can STEM campaign is trying to get more girls involved, to show them just how creative and unexpected and inspiring STEM can be. I personally think it's extremely important for young girls to not be afraid to outwardly show what they're passionate about. So let's tear down these stereotypes and make women the next generation of STEM leaders. Make sure to follow She Can STEM on Instagram to find inspiring stories of women in STEM and resources for getting involved and staying involved in science, technology, engineering, and math.
If I can STEM, so can you.
Check out my description box. Thumbs up if you like this video. And don't let the muggles get you down. Stay gold, starfish. Bye!
But you know, happiness can be found even in the darkest of times. If one only remembers to turn on the light.
Expecto Patronum!